We've got two special parts here. That's one old ECU and the most recent one. Yeah. What are the differences?
Yeah, Nico, we wanted to show also some, like, the inside of an ECU, but this is an old ECU since the interior of the new ECU is something confidential.
So we can't look inside?
You can't look inside, but I'm happy to tell you what you would find inside.
Yeah.
We develop such devices completely in-house. We define the inputs and outputs, which functionality we need, the communications, Ethernet, CAN, LIN buses, and analog inputs, digital inputs, outputs, PWM signals, you name it. We have here in Abstadt a group which develops hardware, software, FPGA, and all of this is, at first we would design the circuit boards in the ECU. We would define the connectors. Again, this is an old device, but it's an open device to show what we are talking about. Anyway, the hardware development, what we do is to design the circuit board, the layout, let's say, to achieve the functionality that we need. Data processing, filtering, voltage stabilizers, to also achieve a certain accuracy for the sensor supply, and so on and so forth. For the MS7, we have actually defined the requirement that the ECU must run without extra cooling, just by the cooling fins, which we have designed with thermal simulation. Mm-hmm. It must be able to run a four-cylinder turbo on full load. It's important to know that this device also contains the amplifiers for injection and ignition, so there are no additional amplifiers, external amplifiers. All of this is driven directly by the ECU. This, of course, generates some heat. Mm-hmm. There is the logger inside, writes the data in parallel to a USB stick, and the design of the housing, the placement of the connectors, using these flex connectors to be able to make the connectors coming out the front, at the small side of the ECU, not sticking up here.
Yeah.
This is all what we do in-house in our hardware development department.
Okay, so over the years it got all packed together. And it actually is smaller, if we have a look and if we compare these ones.
Over the years, it got always more and more compact. I started at Bosch Motorsport in 2009. And at that time, an engine ECU was just an engine ECU. There were no amplifiers internally in the ECU. There was no data logging in the ECU.
So to place external or
extra devices.
As an extra device in a car.
Exactly. Yeah. Now, this is part of what we discussed before, the whole vehicle network. Everything is connected via Ethernet, very easy to configure with the tool that we provide. And it's all in one unit now, data logging, data processing, sensor data gathering, and things like this. Mm-hmm.
Seeing all these little components inside here, I mean, for myself as a non-pro in terms of electronics, how do you know which little panel is for what? And I mean, it's looking really complex, isn't it?
Yeah, we use a so-called platform module, which we have developed and which also includes external components, processors that we buy mm-hmm. as already made parts. This is, let's say, the brain of each device that we sell, and you will also find this platform module in the current ECU. Below this, as a separate board, you find the big board, which incorporates all the sensor information. And we have very good hardware development guys who are doing this for many years now, who know what it actually has to do later on in a race. That it has to be light, that it has to be small. And they have a lot of experience with doing this generation for generation, but also considering new technologies, not only making things always the same, but also trying different approaches with more compact layers and more layers on one board and different technology in connecting the small electronic components, for example, with soldering machines and things like that.
Does different manufacturers want different systems, or is it like most of the manufacturers using the same? I mean, is it like they have a special wish and you construct it especially for them? Or is it like everyone has the experience and they say, okay, we rely on that?
The MS7 is something which is a platform device, and they all use more or less the same device. For the DTM, we have actually developed a specific version which is able to work together with a specific lambda sensor. You can have the lambda probe behind the turbocharger. It's less stress for the lambda probe, and you can have the lambda probe before the turbocharger, so it gets very, very hot. It's called lambda ADV, so in advance of the turbocharger. And the MS7 for class 1 runs with this, so this made it, let's say, a bit specific, but generally it's a platform device. You would also find this in GTE customer projects or rallying. It's always the same hardware.
Okay. Great, Michael. Thanks for the insight. It was really interesting. And I think also our viewers at home, they got some great information.
Great. Excellent. Thanks. Thank you.